Would you read the first text, which is Philippians 3, 13 and 14?
Dok se prezentacija priprema, pročitat ćemo prvi tekst koji se nalazi u Filipljanima, trećem poglavlju, u 13. i 14. stihu. Braćo, ja još ne mislim da sam dostigao, jedno pak velim, što je odstrak zaboravljam, a za onim što je napred sežem se i trčim biljezi k daru gornjega zvanja Božjega u Hristu Isusu.
This evening I want to talk a little bit about the experience of our first official overseas missionary, Pastor Jan Andrews.
Ja želim večeras da govorim o našem prvom zvaničnom internacionalnom misionaru, pastoru Andrewsu.
He authored the History of the Sabbath, a book on the Sabbath.
On je autor knjige Istorija subote.
He was the third president of the General Conference.
On je bio treći predsjednik generalne konferencije.
He was the editor of our church paper, the Review and Herald, for a couple of years.
Bio je urednik crkvenog glasila Review and Herald u toku niza godina.
And he was a brilliant scholar.
I bio je briljantan učenjak.
As a teenager growing up in the state of Maine, northeastern United States.
On je odrastao kao tinejdžer u državi Maine u severoistočnom delu Amerike.
He asked his father, Edward Andrews, to buy some books for him.
Tražio je od njegovog oca, Edwarda Andrewsa, da mu kupi neke knjige.
What kind of books did that teenager want his father to buy?
A kakve bi knjige jedan tinejdžer tražio od njegovog oca da mu kupi?
Books that so he could teach himself to read the Bible in Greek, Hebrew and Latin.
Knjige koje bi mu pomogle da nauči da čita Bibliju na grčkom, jevrejskom i latinskom.
Eventually John could read the Bible in seven languages.
Na kraju je John bio u stanju da čita Bibliju na nekoliko jezika.
And he also acknowledged that he was able to reproduce the entire New Testament from memory if all copies were lost.
I na kraju je rekao da bi mogao da da izgovori čitav Novi Zavet na pamet kada bi sve kopije bile izgubljene.
So it's a little wonder that Ellen White said to the early believers here in Europe, we sent you the ablest man in all our ranks.
I nije čudo što Ellen White rekla tim prvim vernicima Adventističke crkve ovde u Evropi, poslali smo vam jednog od najboljih kojeg imamo u našim redovima.
Here's a photograph of Pastor Andrews' family.
Ovo je fotografija porodice pastora Andrewsa.
His beloved wife Angeline, they apparently had a very close relationship.
Tu je njegova voljena žena Angeline, sa kojom on bio veoma blizak.
And two of their children, Charles and Mary.
I dvoje njihove dece, Charles i Mary.
And they had two other children that had already died before this photograph was taken.
A imali su još dvoje dece koja su umrla pre nego što je ova fotografija snimljena.
Tragically, Angeline died in 1872.
Tragično, Angelina je umrla 1892. 72. godine.
2 years before Elder Andrews was sent to Europe as our first missionary.
2 godine pre nego što je on poslat u Evropu kao naš prvi misionar.
In 1874,
1874. godine,
Pastor Andrews and two of his children set sail from Boston in the United States to go to England.
Pastor Andrews i njegovo dvoje dece otplovili su iz Bostona za Englesku.
He was a single parent, we would say today, they called him a widower back then.
On je bio samohrani otac, rekli bismo danas.
Charles was 16 when they left America.
Njegov sin Charles imao je 16 godina kada su napustili Ameriku.
Because I don't come back to Charles, I'll just tell you now, and later in his life, he stayed in Europe, married a Swiss girl.
Pošto se više neću vraćati na njegovo ime, mogu da vam kažem da se on oženio jednom Švajcarkinjom, ostao u Evropi i tu proveo čitav svoj život.
And eventually he did return to the United States where he worked for the Review and Herald.
A onda se na kraju vratio u Sjedinjene Američke Države i radio je za Review i Herald.
Now his younger sister Mary.
A njegova mlađa sestra Mary.
She turned 13 as just after they got to England.
Napunila je 13 godina samo što su stigli u Englesku.
This was before they went on to Switzerland, which was their ultimate destination.
To je bilo pre nego što stigli u Švajcarsku, što je bilo njihovo krajnje odredište.
They first settled in Neuchâtel, Switzerland.
I prvo su se naselili u Neuchâtelu u Švajcarskoj.
Charles would go down to the market to buy food.
Charles je otišao na pijacu da kupi nešto hrane.
He would bring it home to his younger sister.
Donao je to svojoj mlađoj sestri.
And she, because there was no mother, she was the cook for the family.
I pošto nije bilo majke, ona je bila kuvarica u porodici.
Pastor Andrews wanted to start a paper as part of the mission work, the beginning of the mission work in Europe.
Pastor Andrews je želeo da počne da izdaje časopis koji bi bio sastavni deo njegovog misionarskog rada u Evropi.
And he was told that the printers in Basel, Switzerland were much better than the ones in Neuchâtel.
I rekli su mu da su izdavači u Bazelu, u Švajcarskoj, mnogo bolji nego u mestu u kojem su se naselili.
So the family moved to Basel and lived in this building.
I porodica se preselila u Bazel i živeli su u ovoj zgradi.
And in July of 1876,
1876. godine, jula meseca,
the first issue of the French Science of the Times was published.
Bio je izdat prvi broj časopisa Znaci vremena.
Many of the articles were translations into French from the American Review and Herald or the American Science of the Times.
I mnogi članci bili su samo prevodi članaka koji su i izašli u američkom izdanju.
Though some of the articles were written by Jane Andrews.
A neke članke je napisao i sam Andrews.
The articles would be translated into French by a French translator.
Francuski prevodioci prevodili su članke na francuski.
Set in type by a French typesetter.
I onda su to kucali na mašini za štampa, za kucanje na francuskom.
And then proofread by a French proofreader.
I onda su posao odradili lektor i korektor za francuski jezik.
Now the Andrews family were committed to learning French.
A porodica Andrews je bila spremna da nauči francuski jezik.
So they made a covenant between them, and actually all three of them signed this covenant.
I tako su napravili jedan sporazum i svo troje je potpisalo taj sporazum.
That they would only speak French for 23 hours out of each day.
Da će u toku 23 sata svakog dana govoriti samo na francuskom.
But during one hour they could speak English.
A u toku samo jednog sata mogu da govore na engleskom.
I can imagine that at least initially when that hour came everybody started talking.
Ja mislim kada bi došao taj sat za engleski jezik, tada bi zapravo svi počeli da govore.
Mary had a great ability, a facility for languages like her father.
A Mary je imala veliki dar za učenje jezika kao i njen otac.
In fact, it's reported that she was soon speaking French like a French girl.
I zato je rečeno da je uskoro ona govorila francuski kao prava francuskinja.
So when the issues of the paper, the French Signs of the Times, were being published,
i kada je prvo izdanje francuske verzije Znaka vremena bilo izdato,
after everything that we just mentioned, then when the proofreader had gone through it, it would be given to Mary.
Kada bi korektor odradio svoj posao, tekst je ponovo dat Mary.
So she could find mistakes that the French proofreader had missed.
I ona je trebalo da ona pronađe greške koje je francuski korektor propustio, promašio.
We should never, you know, in any way diminish what our young people can do.
I zato ne smemo ni na koji način da podcenjujemo ono što su mladi ljudi u stanju da ostvare, da urade.
Tragically.
Tragično.
One day Mary began to cough.
Jednog dana Mary je počela da kašlje.
They thought it was a cold.
Mislili su da je prehlada.
But it didn't go away.
Ali ta prehlada nekako nije prestajala.
Concerned about his daughter's cough.
I sada zabrinut zbog kašljanja svoje kćeri.
Elder Andrews took her to the doctor there in Switzerland.
Starešina Andrews ju je odveo kod lekara u Švajcarskoj.
He examined the young girl.
On je pregledao mladu devojku.
And said your daughter has consumption, or today we would say tuberculosis.
I on je rekao vaša kćer ima sušicu jeftiku, danas bismo rekli tuberkulozu.
And I have nothing to suggest by way of a cure for your daughter.
I rekao je ja nemam nikakav lek koji bi mogao da predložim za vašu ćerku.
In mid 1878.
Negde sredinom 1870-ih.
James White, the president of the General Conference in Battle Creek, wrote to Elder Andrews in Switzerland.
James White je napisao pismo Andrewsu.
and said, "Would you come to the Battle Creek, come to Battle Creek to the General Conference session and give a report?"
Da li bi mogao da dođeš na zasedanje generalne konferencije u Battle Creek i da podneseš izveštaj?
This was exciting news for the members of the church.
To je bila uzbudljiva novost za vernike crkve.
I mean, they had a real life missionary that could come home and give a real live report at a general conference session.
Znači da dođe stvarni živi misionar i da održi, da podnese ovaj pravovremeni stvarni izveštaj na zasedanju generalne konferencije.
It's the first time that had ever happened in the history of our church.
To je zapravo da se prvi put tako nešto i desilo u istoriji naše crkve.
And Elder Andrews wrote back and said, "Yes, I'll certainly come."
I starešina Andrews je odgovorio na ovo pismo i rekao je, sigurno je da ću doći.
But may I bring my daughter Mary with me?
Ali je pitao, mogu li da povedem i moju čerku Mary sa sobom?
At my expense.
O ličnom trošku.
His daughter is dying.
A njegova čerka je umirala.
And yet Elder Andrews could not bring himself to think, to ask the church to pay to transport her, to have her travel across the Atlantic Ocean back to Battle Creek.
On nikako nije mogao da podnese tu misao da traži od crkve da crkva pokrije njene troškove putovanja do Battle Creeka.
But Elder Andrews had one goal in mind.
Ali on je imao zapravo jedan cilj na umu.
He wanted his daughter to get to the Battle Creek Sanatorium.
Želeo je da njegova čerka dođe do sanatorijuma u Battle Creeku.
Oh, by the way, this is the way it looked in 1878.
Evo kako je izgledala 1878. godine.
So as soon as they got to
sanatorium.
Battle Creek.
I čim su stigli u Battle Creek?
Elder Andrews takes his dying daughter, his sick daughter to see Dr. John Harvey Kellogg.
I čim su došli u Battle Creek, on je poveo svoju ćerku koja je bila smrtno bolesna na pregled kod doktora Johna Harveya Kelloga.
Elder Andrews was hoping that maybe Dr. Kellogg, just newly graduated from medical school, would know something about tuberculosis that the doctors in Switzerland didn't know.
On se nadao da Dr. Kellogg, koji je upravo završio medicinski fakultet, možda zna nekakvo rešenje, neki lek za njegovu ćerku.
But after examining Mary,
ali kada je pregledao Mary,
Dr. Kellogg came to the same conclusion that the doctors in Switzerland had come to.
Dr. Kellogg je došao do istog zaključka do kojeg je došao i lekar u Švajcarskoj.
She has consumption.
Ona je imala tuberkulozu.
And there is nothing that I can offer you to help cure her.
I on je rekao, ne postoji ništa što mogu da ti ponudim kao lek za njeno isceljenje.
Day by day, Elder Andrews would sit there by the bedside of his dying daughter in the sanitarium.
Iz dana u dan, starešina Andrews je sedeo pored kreveta svoje čerke na umoru u sanatorijumu u Battle Creeku.
Dr. Kellogg would come in and say, "Elder Andrews, you must come out, you'll contract tuberculosis."
Dr. Kellogg bi došao i opominjao ga, moraš da izađeš i ti ćeš sam dobiti tuberkulozu.
But he felt he couldn't leave.
Ali on je nekako osjećao da ne može da ode.
Because his daughter had no one else to be with her.
Jer njegova čerka nije imala nikog drugog da bude pored nje.
Mary Andrews died.
Mary Andrews je umrla.
November 27, 1878.
27. novembra 1878. godine.
She was 17 years of age.
Imala je samo 17 godina.
In an autograph album that they have in their heritage room, their Adventist Heritage Collection at Loma Linda University.
I u jednom autografskom albumu koga imaju na Loma Linda univerzitetu u toj sobi za zaostavštinu.
Elder Andrews wrote something the day after the death of his daughter.
Starešina Andrews je napisao nešto samo jedan dan posle smrti njegove kćeri.
Yesterday morning at 4:30 my dear daughter Mary F. Andrews fell asleep in death.
Juče ujutru u 4:30 moja draga ćerka Mary zaspala je smrtnim snom.
This child rendered me great assistance in Europe.
Ovo moje dete pružilo mi je veliku pomoć u Evropi.
And when we encountered privation and want, she met all with invincible courage.
I kada smo se suočili sa poteškoćama,
she faced them all with courage.
Ona se svima njima suprotstavila hrabrošću.
And with patience, he says, and faith and hope.
I strpljenjem, i verom, i nadom.
What she suffered caused her to fall by the quick consumption.
Ono što je pretrpela učinilo je da brzo umre od tuberkuloze.
She has fallen in the work at a time when her services had become of great value.
Ona je postala žrtva posla koji je imao veliku vrednost.
Who is there that will rise up to take her place?
Ko je taj koji će ustati i sada zauzeti njeno mesto?
And he signed it Jane Andrews, dated it and signed it Jane Andrews.
I onda je potpisao to sa James Andrews.
Elder Andrews found the loss of Mary simply overwhelming.
Gubitak Mary je bio prevelik gubitak za starešinu Andrewsa.
For weeks, he was prostrated with grief.
Sedmicama je ležao slomljen bolom.
Somehow he could not understand why he had been called upon to make such a sacrifice.
I nekako nije mogao da razume zašto je pozvan da podnese tako veliku žrtvu.
He said to a friend,
rekao je jednom prijatelju,
I seem to be having hold upon God with a numb hand.
Čini mi se kao da se držim za Boga, ali ukočenom praznom rukom.
Ellen White was in Texas at the time Mary died.
Ellen White je bila u Teksasu u vreme kada je Mary umrla.
But she wrote a letter to the grieving father.
Ali je napisala pismo o ucveljenom ocu.
And she said, I was shown you with head bowed down and mourning as you followed Mary to her last home in this world.
I ona kaže, pokazan si mi oborene glave kako ispraćaš Mary do njenog mesta počivanja. Yes.
Then I saw the Lord look lovingly upon you.
A onda sam videla kako Bog sa naklonošću gleda na tebe.
I saw the life giver come and your wife and children come forth from their graves.
Videla sam kako svetli anđeo dolazi i kako tvoja deca i žena ustaju iz grobova.
Clothed with immortal splendor.
U proslavljenom besmrtnom telu.
And she signed it, your sympathizing sister, Ellen G. White.
I potpisala je pismo tvoja sestra koja se osjeća sa tobom, Ellen White.
Jane Andrews preached the dedicatory sermon for the famous Dime Tabernacle.
Kada je poznati Dime Tabernacle crkva bila posvećena, on je održao propoved posvećenja.
That was in April of 1879.
To je bilo u aprilu 1879. godine.
And the following month he returned to Europe.
A sljedećeg mjeseca vratio se u Europu.
And if possible, he threw himself into the work with even more determination.
I onda se bacio na posao sa još većom predanošću.
Why?
Zašto?
Because there was one more grave in Mount Hope Cemetery in Rochester, New York.
Zato što je ostavio još jedan grob u Rochesteru u New Yorku.
Buried next to his beloved Angela, now is his beloved daughter Mary.
Do njegove voljene Angelin, sada je bila njegova voljena ćerka Mary.
Here again is a picture of Jane Andrews and his wife.
I evo ponovo slike Johna Andrewsa i njegove žene.
A few years after Elder Andrews returned to Europe,
nekoliko godina nakon što se starešina Andrews vratio u Europu,
one day he began to cough.
Jednoga dana počeo je da kašlje.
At first they thought it was just a cold.
U početku su mislili da je to samo prehlada.
But it didn't go away.
Ali ta prehlada nije prolazila.
And a doctor confirmed the fears that Elder Andrews also had contracted tuberculosis.
I doktori su potvrdili strahove da je i on također dobio tuberkulozu.
As the disease progressed, it ravaged his body.
I kako se bolest razvijala, sve je više uništavala njegovo telo.
Jane Andrews' widowed mother was living in the United States.
Njegova majka, koja je bila udovica, koja je živjela u Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama.
She heard about her son.
Čula je o stanju u kojem se nalazi njen sin.
And she wanted to go to Switzerland to minister to him.
I želila je da ode u Švajcarsku da mu posluži.
Elder Andrews said, no, I don't want my mother to see me in this emaciated condition.
Ali on je rekao, ne želim da me majka vidi u ovom jadnom stanju.
But others intervened and eventually Sarah Andrews came to Europe.
Ali drugi su se ljudi umešali, ubedili ga i konačno Sarah Andrews je došla u Evropu.
Realizing that unless God chose to heal him, he could not live long.
Shvatajući da ako ga Bog ne isceli, da neće dugo poživeti.
Elder Andrews worked as hard as he could writing and editing articles for future issues of the Signs of the Times.
Radio je što je više mogao na pisanju i izdavanju članaka koji bi se mogli kasnije štampati u brojevima znaka vremena.
Given his brilliant mind,
pošto je imao tako briljantan um,
everyone knew that if he died before he finished those articles, none of them would be able to finish them.
Svi su znali da ako umre pre nego što završi te članke, niko drugi neće biti u stanju da ih završi.
We're told that he would come down from his room for breakfast.
I priča se da je silazio iz svoje sobe za doručak.
He would look down at the table at whatever they were serving for breakfast that day.
Pogledao bi šta je na stolu, šta su poslužili za doručak tog dana.
And with tears streaming down his cheeks,
i dok su mu suze tekle niz obraze,
he would mutter to himself,
govorio je sam sebi, mrmljao sebi u bradu.
If only I could force myself to eat, I would have strength to carry on.
Ako kad bih samo mogao da nateram sebe da jedem, stekao bih snagu da mogu da nastavim.
But the disease had completely robbed him of his appetite.
Ali ta bolest mu je potpuno oduzela apetit.
And eventually he would get up and shuffle back to his room.
I na kraju bi odustao od doručka i odvukao se do svoje sobe.
During this period,
u toku tog
he wrote a letter to his brother-in-law Uriah Smith.
Napisao je pismo svom zetu Uriah Smithu,
who was the editor of the church paper.
Koji je bio urednik crkvenog glasila.
And because we're out of time, I won't read all of this.
I pošto nemamo vremena dovoljno, neću čitati čitavo pismo.
But in essence, what he says is, when you have to announce my death.
Ali suština pisma je, kada dođe trenutak da treba da objaviš moju smrt,
make it as simple an announcement as possible.
Molim te da to bude što je moguće jednostavnije.
Don't include any words of eulogy.
Nemoj sada nekakve reči slavljenja, hvaljenja da upotrebiš.
He says, I'm afraid that if I don't make this request, you'll say some things that shouldn't be said about me.
Jer kaže, bojim se ako ne uputim jedan ovakav zahtev, možda ćeš reći nešto što ne bi trebalo da se govori o meni.
He said, my best acts have had some trace of selfishness in them.
Jer kaže, i moji najbolji napori i postupci imaju tragova sebičnosti u njima.
Or have been lacking in love towards God and man.
Ili možda imaju nedostatak, nemaju dovoljno ljubavi prema Bogu i ljudima.
So please don't eulogize me into something that I'm not.
Zato molim te, nemoj da me veličaš i da me hvališ.
This is the house where our headquarters, or the building where our headquarters was in Basel, Switzerland at that time.
Ovo je kuća gdje je bilo naše središte u Bazelu, u Švajcarskoj u to vreme.
And Elder Andrews had an apartment here in this building.
I u toj zgradi starešina Andrews je imao stan.
The last several weeks of his life, he was bedridden.
A posljednjih nekoliko sedmica svog života on je bio potpuno vezan za krevet.
By this time he was too weak to work on any of the unfinished articles that were still on his desk.
U to vrijeme bio je suviše slab da bi mogao da radi na onim nezavršenim člancima koji su još uvijek bili na njegovom radnom stolu.
The weekend of October 19 to 21, 1883.
U tokom vikenda od 19. do 21. oktobra 1883 godine.
The few workers that we had in Basel, or in Europe, I should say, came to Basel for meetings.
Tih nekoliko službenika koje smo imali u Evropi došli su u Basel, u Švajcarsku.
Several times during that weekend they came upstairs from their meetings to pray around the bedside of their dying leader.
Nekoliko puta bi tokom tog sastanka došli u njegovu sobu pored njegovog kreveta da se mole za vođu.
On Sunday morning, October 21,
u nedjelju ujutru 21. oktobra,
in his illness, Elder Andrews apparently had lost track of which day it actually was.
U toj svojoj bolesti i muci, on je očigledno zaboravio i izgubio smisao o tome koji je dan, koje je vreme.
From the few comments that he made, those that were tending him or taking care of him thought that it was October 22, the anniversary of the great disappointment.
Oni koji su brinuli o njemu kažu da je on smatrao da je 22. oktobar, da je to godišnjica onog velikog razočarenja.
There on his bed.
I tako je on tu ležao na krevetu.
The dying man apparently thought of one other thing he wanted to do.
taj umirući čovjek, čovjek na samrti, mislio je o nečem što je još želeo da uradi.
And barely a whisper he asked if someone would bring him a pencil and a piece of paper.
I jedva čujnim šapatom pitao je da li bi neko mogao da mu donese komad papira i olovku.
Why do they see want pencil and paper, they thought to themselves.
I svi su se pitali, pa zašto bi sada tražio papir i olovku?
He hasn't written anything for weeks.
Sedmicama nije ništa zapisao.
But someone went to his office and brought the dying man a piece of paper and a pencil.
Ali neko je otišao u njegovu kancelariju i zaista doneo ono što je čovjek na samrti tražio, parče papira i olovku.
With the last strength he had,
i posljednjom snagom koju je sakupio,
he scrawled across that piece of paper,
napisao je na tom parčetu papira,
I leave to the European mission $500.
Ostavljam evropskoj misiji $500.
And he signed his name, Jane Andrews.
I onda je potpisao svoje ime, stavio svoj potpis.
He had made provision for everything else.
J.N. Andrews postarao se za sve.
But as he lay there dying,
i dok je tako ležao umirući,
apparently the thought crossed his mind.
Očigledno na um mu je došla misao.
Even now, is there anything more that I can do for the cause of God?
Postoji li čak i u ovim okolnostima nešto još što bih mogao da učinim za delo Božje?
Yes, there's that $500.
Da, to je bilo to, tih $500 koje je darovao.
That afternoon,
tog popodneva,
the workers came again, surrounded his bedside for another season of prayer.
Ponovo su došli radnici, okružili njegov krevet da se još jednom pomole za njega.
When they got up from the prayer,
kada su ustali sa molitve,
someone looked over at Elder Andrews there in the bed.
Neko je pogledao na starešinu Andrewsa koji je ležao na krevetu.
And they said he's gone.
I rekao je, otišao je.
It's true, he passed away while they were having the prayer.
Izgubili smo ga, umro je dok smo se mi molili.
Now we're told by Ellen White.
Ja sam čuo da je Ellen White rekla
that the work of this church is going to close with even more power and dedication and commitment than that with which it began.
Da će se delo ove crkve završiti sa većom silom i posvećenošću od onih sa kojima je počela.
If so,
ako je to tako,
that means that some generation is going to display the same kind of spirit of sacrifice and commitment as did our pioneers.
To onda znači da će neki naraštaj pokazati istu požrtvovnost i isti duh posvećenosti koji su pokazali i naši pioniri.
I ask you the same question that I ask myself as I'm telling this story.
I ja sada vama postavljam pitanje koje sam postavio samom sebi dok sam pričao ovu životnu priču.
If you,
ako vi,
if I,
ako ja,
did not think we would be alive to see the sun come up tomorrow morning.
Ne smatramo da ćemo živjeti toliko da dočekamo izlazak sunca sutra ujutru.
Among our last conscious thoughts, would we be thinking?
U našim zadnjim svesnim mislima, da li bismo i mi razmišljali?
Is there anything more that I can do for the cause of God?
Postoji još nešto što bih ja mogao ili mogla da uradim za delo Gospodnje?
Are we the generation that gets serious about finishing the work so Jesus can return?
Da li smo mi kao naraštaj dovoljno ozbiljni da završimo delo Gospodnje da bi on mogao da dođe?
If not us,
who? Ako to nećemo biti mi, ko će onda biti?
And if not now?
Ako to neće biti sada,
when?
Kada će biti?